to another edition of Amanda TV. Here at Amanda TV, we showcase African talents to the world. At Amanda TV, we are educating, informative, and everything to empower Africa as it is. I'm Deborah Mubure.
And today on Amanda TV, we have a special guest once introduced to the world, an exceptional talent, a personal friend of mine, someone with an extraordinary ability. I've actually seen very few persons that look like that. And what am I talking about? It's no other person other than the one in studio with us, the personality of Jideofor, popularly called Jide Akunne. Please let's make welcome Jideofor Akunne.
Good afternoon.
Jide, what makes you unique? He said he has not seen your personality before.
Okay.
What is that personality he hasn't seen?
I'm actually an artist. Okay, I'm an artist. I do painting and pencil works too. And I'm also a dancer. I'm a head of a gospel dance group called HL Crew. And we do ballet dance, we do hip hop, we do contemporary, just name it, every style of dance. We just want to, we are trying to create an avenue where people can come and learn various forms of dance. So that's basically the main things I do.
You actually said you do painting and now dancing.
Yes, okay.
And you're a student?
Yes, I'm a student.
Because I want to be very clear now. How are you able to combine you going to school, you dance, and the head of the dance group at that, and now you do painting? How do you combine those things together?
It's not really a big deal combining them because it's something I love to do.
Okay.
So the main what I really do is I try to plan my time very well.
All
right. As a student, thanks to God, I'm not a dull student. Okay, so I don't have problems with my academics.
I am still better now.
And for my arts is actually my hobby. I love to just get joined as young as 4 or 5.
Wow.
So it has been something I love to do. So when I'm free, I start like maybe reading. Maybe I go into my artboard and I just start painting, doing things. Then for the dance, I actually learned dance. It's not actually a talent. It's something I actually went to an academy to learn.
Seriously?
Yes. I actually learned dance.
So you mean I can't just stand up and shake my body and dance?
No, definitely. Everybody dances, but when you take the professional level, you need to go and learn some basics. Things have to be
interesting. So the dance is rock or paint, and you're a student. And from what I gathered, you're
an
optometry. So are you going to
practice
optometry when you're done?
Big question. Especially when the app starts giving you money. I start having troubles to come and dance and dance. How do you practice?
Honestly, it depends on where the money is coming from. If I start practicing after graduating and there's money in, I mean, I'll
an entrepreneur.
<That's a
different one>. Okay, what gets you in the mood of drawing?
Okay, and in the early stages, I start to draw when I'm really bored. Like when there's nothing to do, I just pick up and I start drawing. But the moments where I do my best artworks are usually times when I'm expressing myself, when I have a deep feeling, maybe for example, like heartbreak, not that I've been, for example, when I have something really hitting me and I just express it myself. If I can't do true dance, I express it to my girl, I'm always very good.
Oh, I really want to
see
that. What do you think?
That sounds exciting. Any someone heartbreak, just go see your one and start going.
So how many heartbreaks? Just whisper.
I don't think you should
do
that.
I don't know if you have to get to know that. Don't know how many more are coming.
We don't hope for that anyway.
Yeah,
we'll be talking about Jide the artist, Jide the dancer. So Jide, how do you do both?
Okay. What do you mean? How do I even do? You mean?
You said you're an artist.
Okay.
And you're a dancer.
You know what? There's actually a very big difference between drawing and dancing.
Yes, true.
So when you now see someone that could actually combine both, someone is doing both, how is it possible?
Yes.
Okay. I'll start by saying I learned both of them in separate occasions. Okay. I started drawing very young, then I started dancing later in my life. But
because you're old now.
So most times, it's just recently I went into the internet and I was watching a video on YouTube by David Garibaldi. He's actually a painter, okay, but he specializes in rhythm and hue. which is music and color. Okay, so what he does is that he goes off stage, okay, he dances to music, and while he does that, he paints. So when I saw that, I was like, seriously, I dance and I paint, and see somebody doing both of them here. And I bet I could even dance better than him, so I was like, hey, what am I waiting for? Let me try something like this out. So I went into my room that day after being inspired by him, and I tried something out, and I was like, wow. My roommate who stays with me was like, said, you just do that. I'm like, yes. And so I said to take it off, like, get serious with it. And so right now, I dance, I paint.
I'm sure your roommate saw Santa on a non-Christmas day and was like, wow.
Yes. Do you really have, probably when you're dancing, you have a stage name, you have this name, when you draw, you have your customized name, when you draw someone like, hey, Jide did this, probably because of a crest, something you place as an embossment.
I do, my art name, whenever I draw, my art name is J-penography.
So I guess the J is for Jide.
I think
I'm smart.
Penography has gotten from the word photography.
Okay.
So I just replaced the photo with pen, because I usually use pens to create my artworks. Okay. So I got J-penography in my artworks. Then when I'm presenting on stage, because from the word J-penography, my friends call me J-pen.
Okay.
I didn't actually give myself that name on stage, but already my friend already called me, hey, J-pen, that's J-pen, so that's J-pen, and I'm like, okay.
Very, very exciting. So in painting, are there various types of paintings? Because we'd like our viewers to learn more about it.
Actually, observe what you're talking. You said something about dry painting, brushless.
Yes. We actually have some basic types of painting. We have the dry painting and the wet painting.
Okay.
I specialize more in dry painting, even though I'm still trying to get more hold on the wet painting. So, but dry painting is mainly when you use things like chalk, pastel, pencil, even pen, biros, things like dry painting. But
like the one you see.
Exactly. This is pastel. This is pastel work. It's a dry painting too. But you may not really tell the difference, so the layman will never know the difference. But it's just what the artist feels comfortable with. Most people, wet painting is when you use things like poster color, acrylics,
brushes,
yeah, exactly. So you have to have, with that, you need more control. Because it's controlling wetness, exactly. It doesn't start dripping at all. So it's just, I specialize in dry painting.
But that doesn't mean you really can't work when it comes to wet painting.
Yeah, I can do wet painting.
Talking about that piece behind you, what was the feeling behind this one? It's a lady, right?
Yes.
So were you thinking of her, that special
hand? I actually did this last night.
Okay. Oh my God.
Yeah, that's why I still on the board. I did this last night.
Okay.
I was sleeping and I woke up in the middle of the night. It was just like, I was lonely. And I needed a partner.
Oh boy.
Yes, it rained.
So I just picked up my boy and I said, need something, and voila, this happened.
Be excited. So there's no particular mood, place, yourself,
and drawing. Okay, mood, no. When I'm happy, I do happy drawings. When I'm sad, you see very slow. It depends on how.
So, what was this called? A sleepy drink.
Well, I am tired of all the talk. I am so in for seeing you dance and paint at the same time. I don't know about you.
Seriously, I can't wait.
Then let's see your thing.
Let's do it.
She never slows down. She doesn't know why, but she knows that when she's all alone, feels like it's all coming down. She won't turn around. The shadows are long and she fears if she cries that first tear, the tears will not stop.
It actually stunned me. Especially when he has to turn the downside up.
At first, when he started, I was like, and the next thing, I was like, oh my father, has what came to my mind.
Oh
my God.
Jide, thanks for coming on the show. You've actually been, I don't know, I just can't stop. I almost can't. Thanks for coming on the show. I don't know, before you leave, can I just say a word or two to our viewers out there? It's probably there's someone like you, or even better than you, that loves your summit. I just need a little motivation to do better than you.
I'll just tell you to follow your dreams. Nothing is too difficult. If you put your mind to it, there are going to be challenges, but you have to be able to sacrifice, because at the end, there's something good that's happened, okay?
That sounds like a bad advice.
Thank you very much, Jide. We've come to the end of another exciting episode of Amanda TV. I remain everyone here.
And I'm Isaac.
Please do well to follow us on our Twitter handle, like our Facebook page, visit our website, all displayed on the screen.
And one thing that is important, if you know you're out there and you have an exceptional talent and you think you're good enough to be on this show, please contact us and we'll get through to you.
Have a lovely day.
Welcome.